Alrighty, guys, we are back here with Champion of New Maelstrom. And yes. This is, in fact, a NA/Asia tournament. And up next, we have Descent versus Superboys. Now, Superboys, never seen them play before in my life.
Doesn't matter.
They have an awesome team name.
Yeah. Hype name.
Like, they're called Superboys. And this is going to be our first game on Mines? Or second? I think our first game of the day was on Mines, actually.
Yeah.
First game of the day was on Mines. So this will be our second game today here on Mines. We're going through round one. Round one is actually, tell us of your pig status here in the chat, guys. My pig status, I have 19,000 gold. And so you guys make it sound like I have to buy that pig. I don't.
You're a slice of bacon away from
it. I am a slice of bacon away from that pig. So if I might be grabbing my pig tonight. It sounds like the pig is an important thing. But focusing here on the event.
Right. Yeah, events are happening. So.
We're going to be shifting right on over to our draft here. Now, we can actually see that Superboys is going to be banning out Stitches with Descent and banning out Arthas. Pretty common first bans. I mean, those are two top-tier tanks. I'd say they're the two most common warrior bans we see by a very large margin. And Tyrande first pick, though? That's a different one.
It's strange. I mean, if you were to go back a couple of weeks, maybe you might see that. When she was like hyper strong and like everybody loved just running in with Shadowstalk initiations, but looking at the rest of the team as well, it seems like they just don't know what they're doing. As mean as that is to say for any team, I don't see any synergy with the entirety of Superboy's team.
I mean I can't disagree. We've got the triple support, which is really weird, but they're actually picking up. I mean, Lili is their final pick.
Like, right, it's.
Like Malfurion is still available. Like, if you're going... Alright, so they're very different heroes. Right. But Lili no longer has that mana restoration.
Yeah.
She's... Overall, doesn't have a lot of anything. She doesn't have burst. She doesn't have any kind of lockdown and stun. She just kind of has raw stats. Like, I'm going to give you a good amount of sustain. You can't necessarily... There's no burst with her. Thousand Jugs is great. Don't get me wrong. But Water Dragons actually become a little bit more common here. Do you think we're going to see, like, all three of them? Do you think we're going to see Water Dragon, Emerald Wind, and Starfall? Because it doesn't make sense.
I don't know why we would. If you have Emerald Wind and Water Dragon and use them both at the same time, there's way you're going to guarantee hitting anything. Like, unless you have perfect positioning on both Lili and Brightwing. So I don't know, like...
So
a sustain comp. If it was a sustain comp, they would have Rhaegar and Malfurion instead of Tyrande and Lili.
Here's the best case scenario. Here's the best case scenario. They get a good Maw. Brightwing goes on an offensive side, pushes them back, followed by a Water Dragon, Starfall, Strafe. That's like the dream here, if you will. Like, that would be in an amazing initiation if they managed to get like three people in a Maw and do something like that. But still... It feels like that's such an all-in, like, kind of like we're relying on getting that perfect execution, because without the Maw, I really don't see them doing a lot with this. And I actually think we'll see Reign of Vengeance not straight.
Yeah, I think what we see is Reign of Vengeance, Maw into Reign of Vengeance into Water Dragon plus Tyrande stun, and then maybe like they'll reserve the Emerald Wind for if they feel like it went bad. Or if it went really good, then if Brightwing is able to get into an appropriate position to use it, then yeah, sure, maybe.
But we're in agreement that we're not going to see Blink Heal, because when you have three supports, you really don't need to spend your heroics on healing.
It does not make any sense to have Blink Heal here, especially because we're on Mines. Like, you need... Mines is a lot about positioning, especially in the Mines down bottom. It's a lot about positioning and a lot about how you're going to be moving around. And one Emerald Wind can really, really... separate a fight in Mines down bottom. Like, if Brightwing is able to get in between two people, they only split up like a perfect distance between each other. There's no like, oh, we're just gonna slightly push them off to the side, they'll come back. Like, if she's in the right place, it's gonna completely divide Mines basically in half because the corridors are so small. So that's a thing, and that'll be really cool to see. Zagara is really good down there as well because of the Maw. But when I look at it, I'm like, okay, Team Descent, Nova alone crushes every single
all of them.
Hero.
All
on
of
that
them.
Team.
All five heroes.
Whichever one she picks. Granted, Lili actually not as much because she can blind her, so she'll miss her hotshot. And that's a really big deal. But she's probably not going to aim for Lili anyways. So, like, if Nova's able to take out Vala or Zagara, I don't see any way that Superboy's can bring back a fight.
I mean, this honestly, yeah. We look at the side for Descent, and we talk about that for a little bit. Tassadar as the first pick, very safe. I mean, he's just amazing. Good. He's just good. He's probably the most common first pick of the last ever since the last patch.
Yeah.
He's really just so good. Then we have Tychius, again, a huge pick, and Uther. Uther is considered to be the top healer by many in the game right now. Anubarak, just all the stuns. I mean, we're talking, we have Grenade, we have the E, the hammer from Uther, and we have the double stuns coming out from there. And then, again, Nova, who can just delete anyone. I really like Nova as their last pick because it's like, all right,
yeah,
look at their composition. We can just remove one of their players from the fight. Boom, boom, boom. Goodbye, Tyranda.
Yep.
Goodbye, Brightwing. Whichever they decide. But without further ado, I think we're ready to roll here, and we're going to see how this pans out.
Yes, sir.
For both teams.
All right, and now, anybody that was watching last game will notice a familiar name in here, and that is Fall Monkey. And it makes sense to me now seeing it instead of before. Some of the you can go to live.
Okay, we're gonna get going here.
Yeah, some of the players in the tournament don't have access to North American accounts, or they, whatever the reason is, they needed to share an account in order to actually play in the event. So it happened on a couple accounts. We haven't seen any duplicates yet that I know of, but we do see that Fall Monkey has appeared in two different games. So that's at least one. And we have Faker Fangirl here, just kind of running back and forth on a horse, doing
showing her dance skills. I mean, that horse knows how to do a nice little dance here. And yep, again, like you said, Fall Monkey, multiple games, but account sharing, Blizzard, just
right.
Disregard.
Yeah, it's okay. We'll make it through it.
We'll make it through it. Well, again, this is going to be Haunted Mines, and it's going to be really interesting. I'm just excited to see how Superboy's strategy works out for them, because I, you know, as a support guy, I'm down to see three supports in one game, but I don't know if it's going to pay off. But they could absolutely prove me wrong in this game.
I think I wouldn't mind it as much if it was like a roots build Malfurion
instead of Lili. I agree with that.
Like that would be okay, maybe. But like Falstaff was open, they didn't pick him up, and that just seems wrong.
Well, that minion got blown away by the snipe, not the intended target, as Meteor did kind of juke to the side a little bit there, but Meteor is going to be just fine. Valabot, not as fine. Now, which player was that supposed to be playing on Vala?
That
is a bot presently.
Yeah, it was Xing Liu.
Mm-hmm. I see.
I know that there was a message earlier from Descent, which they said that because Vala disconnected, they didn't go like... They weren't trying to kill her. They didn't realize it at first, and then once they did realize that it was
a bot. So they played Manor.
Yeah, they played Manor.
Hmm.
So hopefully I'm not... I don't know if it's this game or at some point in the tournament, that was announced, and they offered a remake of the game because of the... they offered it right away.
They're just like, hey, you want to rematch?
Yeah.
Because that's really cool to hear that they have so much Manor in that, because... I mean, it seems off the bat they're not going to have a Vala on their side, and with triple support, we might not be able to see their full strategy fulfilled if they're running with a bot, because obviously they have a weird composition they're going with here, and with a Vala bot, it's going to be interesting.
Yeah, it'll be a thing to see if it actually ends up mattering or not. And now this is something that we don't see often: teams getting very, very early giants. It's not something we're normally used to seeing, just because the timing usually coincides too tightly with mines, and it ends up with the enemy team being able to get into mines before you and just kind of, you know, ruining your day. Volibot actually juking like
a
boss.
Gosh, they have nothing on that Volibot they were going for, and she's like, nah, I'm out.
Yeah, I'm not dealing with this.
Maybe that's the meta. Maybe the account is actually named Vala.
Right, yeah, that's... they actually just mind game their way to victory. That's how they do.
Well, we see Meteor here grabbing up these skulls here in the mines. Now, Lili can typically get away pretty easily. Brightwing's going to come in here with the Polymorph to try to get her out, and getting that, you know, the trait that Lili has, the additional move speed to get out of there. But Brightwing? Getting beat on a little bit here.
It's Lili, in that regard, Lili's actually very interesting, where if you hit her with an ability that does less damage than her heals, it's actually not worth hitting her. Because she's going to be using her heals anyways, and if you can't finish her due to that one auto attack that you threw down, then it's not going to matter. Like, she's going to run away too fast and, you know, rip life.
Rip Volibot. Not going too ham on the Volibot. Lies. Lies. Well,
I mean,
at
some point it's going to happen. Yes. Like, Volibot has no mercy. She has no soul. She will try to ruin your day and usually will die because of it.
With the bot AI in this game, they are programmed to go for objectives first and foremost, so she will blindly just run at skulls when they're available on the map.
Right.
Cattlepillar, I have to praise his name. That is a wonderful tag. Like, is it a cattle?
Or it's literally just like a stack of cows. Just going into the sky, just a stack of cows.
Can somebody illustrate this? I want to see a caterpillar in real life. I would love you forever. That's a beautiful thing. Now we have the pressure coming on here in the bottom lane in favor of Superboy's. Wild Descent has a 95 skull golem spawning. It's the first golem of the game. It's early, but it's still a 95 skull golem.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't honestly matter.
Whoa. He got the triple auto attack. That's an incredibly uncommon talent to be grabbing there on Zagara. Now, it's good for pushing back lanes. It's really good for just killing minions. But that's the same tier where he can grab Envenom Spines, which is increased range and damage, or Envenom.
Right.
So really kind of an odd choice for the Zagara player.
Yeah, I mean, they need damage.
They do.
Anywhere they can get it, they're looking for it.
But they don't have the burst.
Right.
And, they don't
have burst, but they do have a sizable amount of sustain. So maybe the idea was, you know what? I'll just auto attack everything at once, and maybe we'll be able to chip through them and take them down.
An interesting.
I'm not sure if I agree with it,
indeed,
but you know,
yeah.
It's there. So this golem should be able to get all the way to the enemy's keep. That means going through this fort and to the enemy keep if they play it right. If they're able to back down Superboys off of this town right here, they'll be able to just go all the way to keep. Whatever they want, it'll be easy to
Yeah, these side storms having continuous value again and again. The Nova can try to pick a snipe here. We can see the Dotorana getting very low. The Clairvoyance down to give them complete vision, and Nova can posture if she likes, but she's falling back a little bit. Her cooldown should be just about ready to roll, and yes, we see her going in for the snipe here on Brightwing. Nice little stun there, but it's not going to be enough to pick anyone down. But again, they're just going to stay with their golem and push.
Yeah, as they should. Looks like a noob is actually backing away. I'm not too sure I agree with this. This golem still has a sizable amount of health. They could definitely push this. They could break wall at minimum if they wanted to, possibly get a pick. And if they got a pick here, they would also hit level 10, which means they could probably just steamroll through and almost get down to the core if they did it.
Yeah, it's a great point. Faker Fangirl is actually pretty low on mana, so they seem to be wanting to just make sure they're playing safe and not throwing away, because the underdog bonus adds up pretty quickly when they're behind. I mean, they know they're going to hit level 10. They want to get this keep to ensure that level 10. Actually, they don't even need it. They're going to probably hit level 10 prior to that. Here it comes. Boom, bam, boom. Level 10 has been achieved. That's the sound effect it makes when you level up.
That's pretty good sound effects. Should get hired by Blizzard. Precision Strike comes out, absolutely ruins the Brightwing. Her little wings go flying through the air. Vala comes back into the game, right into a hammer.
Oh my gosh, Vala is back in the game. Valabot is potentially survives more frequently than this Vala player, but we actually have the Vala player back in the game, so good for them.
Correct.
Well, you know, everything's going in favor of Descent at this point in the game. Getting this kill on Tyrande is absolutely massive. Not too sure what she was thinking, poking out like that by herself. A little bit greedy, just trying to keep some pressure on, but all they had to do is bring on their tower of cows, the Caterpillar, and get that kill with Spray and Pray.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure what they're doing right now. They took Giants, and then they just sort of backed away. They still have the level lead. They still have 3 ults to burn. And the enemy team's only level 8, so there's really no reason why Valmuggy should live
through
this. Oh
my gosh, yeah, and he's living. I mean, the damage was coming out of the Nova, massive damage. Blue Fox has the Archon up, and that is going to do destruction on them. Oh, just a complete obliteration. Brightwing is going to fall. Lili can just run like a little Lili does, and actually, I wish we had an Asmodan in this game, because I've been playing so much Asmo lately. I was ready for that dunk to come down. We didn't have it though. It's okay.
But I mean, it was kind of like a super dunk from the precision strike. So
that's true.
That happened.
That was beautiful. Yeah. It was absolute just carnage, ripping through their team. I believe it took out 3 players with one big precision strike. Now, they're falling back here, realizing that all of their team is up and they are alone. Just two members while the other three are in the mines, rightfully so, just giving up those giants. Not worth throwing away their lives, especially when you consider the underdog bonus. Not even level 10 ready here for Superboys.
Yeah, Superboys is... They need a pick right now. They need to find somebody that gets out of position, preferably Nova or Tychus. They need to get that pick, and then they need to hit 10 off of that, select their ult, and then fight afterwards. But this is not the way you
yes,
do that.
Yes, the way they posture, just waiting here at the door. The precision strike, oh my gosh. I mean, Brightwing, three kills for none. That was absolutely wonderful. Nova was able to delete four kills. That's math. Math is hard.
Math is hard.
It's difficult. It's really hard. But that was just nicely done. Nice, just, you know, observation look. They're going to be coming in the mines. Let's wait and blow them up the moment they walk down here.
Yep, we've been seeing that a little bit more often as we go through the competitive scene. People start saying, like, okay, mines are super important, and people are going to come through, and if they follow us through, we have the jump on them without a doubt. So they'll wait down there, they'll bait it out, and then they'll usually just kind of, you know, ruin things. If you get the jump on someone, if you get the stun down very early, you could do a lot of damage.
Well, nice clairvoyance here, giving complete vision here for Descent, knowing that exact, you know, pretty much forcing Superboys to back up off these knights. They can't take a fight here. Four levels down at this point in the game, more or less three, but it's still four presently. Strafe going in, doing a lot of damage. We're going to see the Odin come down. The Water Dragon is not going to be able to take out Tychus because the Odin soaks up enough damage. A nice attempt. Without Odin, he would fall for sure. The shielding going down on Tychus, letting him live, and Blue Fox is just going to use Phase Shift. What? It's not Phase Shift. That's not the name of it.
Sounds good enough to me.
His little get out there for Tassadar. Now, we see Odin going down. Not Odin. Archon going down. A lot of damage on Lady. The Precision Strike once again, at least forcing them back. Pretty much guaranteeing the kill. This Golem, though, is wrecking havoc. It is a 100 Skull Golem. And
it should be game. This
yes.
should be game out of this.
It should.
If they push appropriately, if they don't overextend. The mod was decent. I think I hit two people. Yeah.
It's just delaying the inevitable. It's delaying the inevitable at this point.
It didn't do enough. And now, the only way that Superboys can bring this back is if somehow Descent just not throws it away, but overextends a little bit too hard, gets caught in some kind of CC and blows up. But it doesn't matter, because they actually just obliterated those two people. So,
well, yeah, I mean, the strafe is just kind of like a last-ditch effort of, hey, look, let's get my damage higher on those charts. Now, granted, that was a Volibot for a good portion of the game, but their composition right. seemed a bit weird.
Yeah, I'm not sure if even with a Vala, they would have been able to really pull too much out of that.
So, yeah, I mean, well, GG to Descent.
I wish I knew what the plan was. I think they went with, it seemed like almost comfort picks, but even then, it didn't shine through as a comfort pick.
I mean, triple support with Lili being one of them. Like we said earlier, if you had the Malfurion and you built Malfurion for Manfurion, where you go with Twilight
right,
Dream,
right.
you spec into Roots, you get Rewind, you have the double Root, and then you have the double Root Twilight Water Dragon, I can see that being a ton of bursts, removing someone from the fight, let alone you pair that with something like Maw. Maw Twilight Dream is terrifying.
Yeah.
Absolutely, utterly terrifying.
Yeah, you can
so,
Maw into a Root into a Twilight Dream as well.
Oh, it's
really good.
It's wonderful. It's wonderful.
Good.
So there's a lot of cool things they could have done with that, but the Lili pick, it didn't work.
It
I mean,
just shut everything down.
Yeah.
Like, it didn't do anything. Like, her healing numbers aren't even that special. Like, she healed 8,000, Brightwing healed almost 12. Taranda actually didn't even throw a single heal, it looks like.
Why? It's not needed.
Yeah,
I mean, it's not going to help that much. Her healing's so low. I mean, I believe she was specking into her arrow as expected, because that's typically how we see Taranda played. But all in all, just some weird picks. Short 10-minute game. Nice decisive win for Descent there. Up next, we have ZNH versus Glorious. And we're just going to be prepping that really quick. We're not going to throw it to commercial because we can do this while we talk.